Hey everyone, I'm Mike, and today we're going to be going over 9 tips that will show you how to fix the connection refused error in Chrome. In a digital world hooked on instant gratification, one of the last things you want to experience when browsing is an error message such as the connection refused error. This can be incredibly frustrating and may even be a sign that something has gone seriously wrong. For the average user, the really confusing errors are the ones that can be hard to distinguish between a problem with your WordPress site and something else, such as a network or browsing issue. The connection refused error message is especially common and usually a non-WordPress site related error message you'll sometimes see in Chrome. Fortunately, it's relatively easy to pinpoint the cause of this problem. In this video, we'll explain how to fix it. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there'll be links and more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. All right, let's get started. Fixing this connection refused error typically involves the following steps. Check to see if the page itself is down. Restart your router. Clear your browser's cache. Assess your proxy settings and adjust them as needed. Temporarily disable antivirus and firewall software. Flush your DNS cache. Change your DNS address. Disable any outdated Chrome extensions and reinstall your Chrome browser. But first, let's take a deeper look into what this error actually means. Unfortunately, encountering errors goes hand in hand with using the internet. There are hundreds of possibilities, from the white screen of death to the classic 404 error to the connection timed out error. When you visit a website using Google Chrome and encounter the message, "This site can't be reached," it means that your attempt to connect was refused. This error code also appears in other browsers. In Mozilla, you'll see the message, "Unable to connect." And in Microsoft Edge, it says, "Can't reach this page." As with most error messages, the connection refused error lets you know that something has gone wrong without being kind enough to tell you why it's happened. This means it's up to you to find and resolve the root issue, if possible. Although the range of potential causes can make troubleshooting tricky, it is possible to fix the connection refused error. Let's walk through 9 steps you can take, starting with the ones most likely to provide an answer. Your first step should be to check the status of the website you're trying to access. As we've already mentioned, the connection refused error can sometimes be caused by the site's server rather than your own internet connection. A simple way to check whether this is the case is to visit another web page. If the error message occurs again, the problem most likely originates with your connection. If the second page loads correctly, however, the first site was probably at fault. You can also check out Down for Everyone or Just Me. Enter the address of the non-functioning page and click on Or Just Me. This site will then assess whether the page is offline or online. Unfortunately, when a page is down, the only thing you can do is wait for it to be fixed. However, if the page is up and still not loading for you, it's time to do some further troubleshooting. As a tried and tested method for fixing many internet-related issues, your next step will be to try turning it off and back on again. Restarting your home or office router doesn't come with 100% guarantee, but the process takes just a few minutes, so it's worth the try when you're dealing with a potential connection issue. To do this, disconnect the power supply from your router. You'll then need to wait for about 30 seconds before plugging it back in. Once the router has booted up again, try to access the page that returned an error. If it loads, then you're good to go. If not, well, then on to the next potential solution. Like any good internet browser, Chrome will store information in its cache on your computer or device. This includes your browsing history, saved login data, and cookies, all of which are recorded in order to load the relevant pages more quickly the next time they're visited. Although they're useful, caches can cause numerous issues when they become outdated. This is because the cached version of a page is likely to no longer match the current live version. Fortunately, this problem is easily solved by clearing your cache. But before you do that, you can easily check to see if it's a browser cache issue by first opening up your browser in incognito mode. Or you can try a different browser. If you're still seeing the error, then you'll want to proceed with clearing your cache. To do so, begin by opening up Chrome's primary menu in the top right corner of your browser window. From there, select More Tools. You can then click on Clear Browser Data. On the resulting page, you'll need to make sure that all the listed file categories are selected. If they aren't, Chrome won't be able to empty the entire cache. Instead, it will remove the most recent entries, which won't result in the desired effect. An alternative method of completing this process is to enter this following URL into your address bar. The resulting screen should grant you access to the same options we've previously discussed. With security threats consistently on the rise, it's no wonder many people are now using individual solutions to protect their sensitive data. A popular way of doing this is through proxy servers. A proxy lets you go online under a different IP address and acts as an intermediary between your browser and the websites you visit. As well as keeping your IP address private, it can also help to filter cache data and server communications. Just as with caching, a proxy server can be useful, but can also cause the connection refused error message. For example, a web server might reject the IP address attached to a proxy server and then reject the actual connection as a result. It's also possible that the proxy is offline or incorrectly configured. In short, if the error message in question occurs, it's worth checking out your proxy settings. Chrome actually has its own proxy section, which can make this step a particularly simple process. After all, you won't need to spend any time searching for the correct tools in your browser. To get started, access the settings menu in your Chrome browser. This will open up the complete menu of options. Under the System section, you'll need to click Advanced at the bottom to see this. You should find an entry titled Open Proxy Settings. By selecting it, you'll be taken to the corresponding menu. Your next step depends on the system you're currently using. Windows users will want to click on LAN Settings and uncheck the Use Proxy Server for LAN option. If you're a Mac user, you should immediately find yourself in the relevant menu. You'll then have to uncheck all selectable proxy protocols and check to see if the connection refused error message has been resolved. Firewalls and antivirus software are intended to protect users and their systems. They scan your device regularly and automatically block any suspicious activity. You may start to notice a recurring theme here. However, this type of advanced security can at times lead to connection issues. This is because firewalls can often block pages they don't need to or reject content that is completely safe. To check whether this is the case for you, try disabling your firewall and antivirus programs. Of course, this is only advised if you know for sure that the site you're intending to visit is safe. Additionally, you should only disable this kind of software temporarily. Switch it back on after you finish checking to see whether the error has been resolved so you don't become vulnerable to attacks. If you repeatedly encounter errors because of your firewall or antivirus software, you may want to consider changing what you're using. As somewhat of an extension to an earlier troubleshooting step, your next task will be to clear your DNS cache. Although most people are aware that their browser creates a cache, not as many know that their operating system does the same thing. For example, your DNS cache contains all of the temporary entries for pages you've accessed within your browser. These entries store key information related to the domain names and addresses of the pages you visited. The purpose of this feature is similar to that of other types of caches. It accelerates the loading process as it eliminates the need to contact a site's DNS server repeatedly. This will save you time in the long run. However, you may occasionally see some short-term issues. If a stored entry no longer matches the current version of the website it refers to, technical errors like the connection refused error message are not unusual. Fortunately, clearing your DNS cache is a quick and easy solution. Again, how you'll do this will depend on your operating system. With Windows, you'll launch the Start menu by pressing the Windows key and search for CMD. This should return the command prompt. In the command prompt, run the following command. You will then see a confirmation that it has successfully flushed the DNS resolver cache. On a Mac, you'll need to do the following. Click on Go up in the Finder toolbar, and then click on Utilities. Open the terminal, run the following command, and you'll need administrator access to do this. When you've done that, try accessing the problem site again. Hopefully, if you followed all of our advice, it should be working by now. If not, your DNS may require some more attention. As we discussed before, an outdated DNS cache entry is a potential source of issues like the connection refused error. However, the DNS address itself can also be responsible for these kinds of problems. This is because it can become overloaded or even go completely offline. In the majority of cases, your DNS server address is automatically obtained from your internet provider. However, you can change it if required. How you'll do this will again depend on the operating system you're using. Let's explore how Mac users can complete this process. First, you'll need to open up System Preferences. On the resulting screen, select the option marked Network. You'll then need to click on Advanced. From there, select the DNS option found at the top of the screen. To add a new DNS server, click on the plus button. To edit an existing DNS server instead, double-click on the DNS IP address you wish to adjust. You can try temporarily changing these to a public DNS server, such as Google or Cloudflare. Some prefer to use Google's public DNS long-term due to them sometimes being more reliable. Cloudflare also offers its secure and blazing fast free DNS. Here's a tip. If you're already using a free DNS server and having issues, removing it and defaulting back to your ISP's DNS servers also sometimes fixes things. Google and Cloudflare aren't perfect 100% of the time, and there have been a few instances where we've noticed switching back has resolved the issue. Once you've changed your DNS address, you can then attempt to access the site again, and cross your fingers. There's no denying that installing extensions often contributes to a more well-rounded Google Chrome experience. The many extensions offered can add key features and even help to automate complex processes. However, a large number of the extensions available for Google Chrome are not developed by the browser's developers. Instead, they're usually created by third parties. This can mean there's no real guarantee they'll work as you intend, or they will be correctly updated over time. Incorrect or outdated extensions are likely to cause numerous issues, including the connection refused error message. For this reason, it's important to regularly audit the extensions that are attached to your browser. To do that, first open the extensions menu in your Chrome browser. You can then begin to assess each of your installed extensions in turn. Start by questioning whether you actually need each one. If an extension is no longer necessary, you can remove it. Next, find out when each extension that you want to keep was last updated. Ideally, it should have been updated within the last 3 months. Any longer than that could be a sign that the extension is being neglected by its developers. If possible, you want to remove those extensions and replace them with newer alternatives. Of course, new and fully updated extensions can still sometimes cause problems. If you suspect that this is the case, begin by disabling all of your attached extensions. If the site you've been trying to access loads after doing this, you'll know that at least one of them is at fault. You can then reactivate one extension at a time until you've honed in on the problem software. As with any other application, Chrome itself is never going to be completely bug-free. Your installation of the browser can contain various issues, especially if it hasn't been updated in a while. What's more, problems between your browser and operating system are surprisingly common. As a result, sometimes the only solution is to completely reinstall Chrome. You can do this by removing the current installation from your device. You can then download the most recent version of the browser by visiting the official Chrome website. So you may be wondering, what if none of these solutions work, Mike? This is usually a sign that something more serious is wrong on the server side. In other words, with the website itself. Unfortunately, in this scenario, the only thing you can do is be patient. It's likely that the website's owners are working hard to resolve any issues, and things will resume like business as usual before too long. If accessing the site is a matter of urgency, you could try reaching out to its owners directly. There are numerous ways to do this, although social media and email are particularly effective and unlikely to be affected by any website downtime. You want to explain the problem you're facing and mention that you've tried several solutions to no avail. Hopefully, the team behind the website gets back to you to discuss the best course of action. You may even be doing them a favor if you happen to make them aware of an issue they don't know was preventing access to their site. If you're a Kinsta client and it's your own WordPress site that is having the issues, feel free to reach out to our support team. We are here 24/7 to help. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.